Amelia Hartley arrived at Blackwood Manor on a dreary autumn afternoon, the sky heavy with dark clouds that threatened rain. The old estate loomed before her, its stone facade weathered and ivy-covered, casting a forbidding shadow over the surrounding countryside. Amelia shivered, both from the chill in the air and a sense of unease that seemed to settle over her like a second skin. As she stepped through the grand oak doors of the manor, Amelia felt as though she had entered another time. The air was heavy with the scent of must and decay, and the only sound was the echo of her footsteps on the marble floors. The portraits lining the walls stared down at her with cold, unseeing eyes, their subjects long dead and gone. Her research into the history of Blackwood Manor was slow going at first, the old records and documents yielding little information. But as Amelia persisted, delving into dusty archives and long-forgotten letters, a story began to emerge. A story of love and betrayal, of greed and murder. And at the center of it all was the tragic figure of Lady Catherine Blackwood, whose spirit was said to still roam the halls of the manor, seeking vengeance on those who had wronged her. The more Amelia learned, the more she felt the weight of Lady Blackwood's presence pressing down upon her. Shadows seemed to dance at the edges of her vision, and she often caught glimpses of a figure out of the corner of her eye, only for it to vanish when she turned to look. But Amelia was not one to be easily frightened, and she was determined to unravel the mystery of Blackwood Manor, no matter the cost. It was during one particularly stormy night, as the wind howled outside and rain lashed against the windows, that Amelia's determination was put to the test. She awoke to the sound of footsteps in the hallway outside her room, slow and deliberate, as if someone, or something, was making its way towards her. Heart pounding, she crept to the door and peered out into the darkness, but there was nothing to be seen. And yet, she could feel a presence in the room with her, cold and malevolent, filling her with a sense of dread. In that moment, Amelia knew that she was not alone in Blackwood Manor, and that the spirit of Lady Catherine Blackwood was determined to make her pay for uncovering the secrets of the past. With trembling hands, she reached out to Thomas Blackwood, the groundskeeper who had become her ally in this dark and dangerous journey, and together they prepared to face the vengeful spirit head-on. The final confrontation with Lady Blackwood was a harrowing ordeal, with the very walls of the manor seeming to shake with her rage. But Amelia stood her ground, her eyes blazing with determination, as she confronted the spirit and demanded answers for the sins of the past. And as the first light of dawn crept through the windows, the ghost of Lady Blackwood finally laid to rest, her curse lifted from Blackwood Manor at last. As the estate bathed in the soft glow of morning, Amelia knew that her time at Blackwood Manor had been a journey she would never forget. The haunting of the manor was over, its secrets laid bare for all to see, and she could finally leave knowing that she had faced the darkness and emerged stronger for it. And as she walked away from the old estate, the sun shining bright overhead, Amelia felt a sense of peace settle over her, knowing that she had played a part in bringing redemption to a place long shrouded in sorrow.